hard dice.
Welcome to this stateless Codecast. This is episode number 56 in our series, Create a RubyGem, Nerd Dice. And in this episode, we're going to... Last episode, we broke up the Nerd Dice module into a series of smaller source code files. So we're going to refactor the repeated code that we had in our role ability scores spec, and then move the files that we have in the folders to match the new hierarchy that we've got. So right now we've got Nerd Dice has class methods, and class methods has a series of folders here. And then in Nerd Dice, the execute die roll and refresh seed and some of those other ones are all kind of in a flat hierarchy. So I want to create a class methods folder there and kind of have it match the values that are in there so that they're in the same hierarchy. So we'll create a new folder in our specs directory. Class methods directory. We're going to potentially anything that relies on shared examples, we'll have to change the require path on those potentially. Let me see. Shared examples, execute die roll methods. So I think we should be okay on those. I'll try doing this. So we're going to do clear things out. CD spec nerd dice, and we're going to do a git move to try the first one, see if we broke anything. Did not break stuff, so go back to our directory here, do the same thing for configuration spec. We actually want to leave the same because that's got its own class associated with it, and that those are the things about the class itself. So next we have dice set die configuration, which I think is what we want. So we had 334 examples. Let's make sure that we still have 334 examples. We do. RuboCop doesn't have a problem with this. These are all just renaming and moving. I'm actually going to make this part of the previous commit, and then I'm going to force push. So and helps if I put two M's in commit. For some reason, it's treating this as a Ruby file rather than a git commit message. So we'll sign this, take a look at our log. Think I should be good to force push this. We will let our GitHub actions complete here while we're waiting for that to finish. We'll take a look at our commit history on this branch, make sure that it reflects what we want. Oh, and we have a failure. Let's see what happened. Benchmark. Nine thousandths of a second. So total dice secure random. So this is one of the ones that has been around for a while. We'll bump that up. Git commit amend again. Take a look at our commit history. So it's got the new items that we were looking at. We'll let that finish. Our action has passed. So now we want to get into refactoring this role ability scores spec. Right now, no, I think I do want to keep it, to have it be a new file here. So we'll look at the example we had for So I've created three new shared example files, one for ability method, square method with ability options, with no ability options, and with dice options. So we will want this to be similar to what we did. We'll make it named the right way. We've got these three now. I'm going to go back and make a shared example in the rollability score spec itself. This is where we're going to put the array part of this. So we'll try getting that part working before we go in and require the other items. Got that. Now we want to have a behaves like block here. So we'll try this behaves like block. Try it. We're failing. Failing a pretty big block here. Hold on. So I created an infinite loop there. Let me see if I can just do it without the block and have it work. So that worked. But yeah, if that just works, then that should be able to just work for all of them. Should stay constant at 27. It does. Just make sure that we have I don't think we're actually using this anywhere, are we? No, I just so we want pause and write these. I've got my require statements. Let's make sure that we're still working as intended. Now we want to go in and for each of these. So this is with out options. It's got the four it blocks. With no ability options. So this is our example here. And I hope that I can just go in here and do the second it behaves like statement. Not. Config. So that might be because I did it with the wrong. Yeah, I put it in the wrong place. Oops. So that's still working. Still with 27. So now this is with options. With ability score options. Should stay at 27 down to 23. With ability options. Save the file. Let's see if we're back up to 27. We are. It looks like that's still working the way we want it to. Now we want to take a look at the with dice options here. Three items will be what we provide to that method, or those shared examples. We've got it saved. Now we need to replace method here with the behaves like statement. So I want to get rid of one do it in the place where I'm removing the stuff. So, still at 27. And then we now want to make this have width with ability options here. Stay at 27. It does. And then the other one, it behaves like ability scores with no ability options. And with dice options. Stay at 80%. All right, now we want to go, so our code coverage is reduced here. Let's run the whole suite and make sure that I'm not missing code. No, we're at 100% overall when we do that, so I think we're all right there. Take a look at our new and improved roll ability scores spec. So I think that gives us what we want there. We'll make sure everything's saved. We will make sure the road pirates I think that's what RuboCop was upset about. So rerun our specs. I think we're good here. And then we will take a look at our code coverage. Still at 100. Write our message. So I've got my commit message. I'll sign it. Push the new code. Evaluate the GitHub action. Our build is passing. Go to our project. Move this backlog item to done.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.